Hey guys, PJ Bottoms is back again with his review of the second story by Peter Chimera, which is called Resident Deadly. It's pretty bad. Luckily, it's very short, so I may be able to fit another story in this. Of course, considering how short most of the stories are, I might be able to fit three or four. Anyway, this is a Resident Evil fic called Resident Deadly. It's one of his 12 stories. It's rated T, it's English, it's a horror romance, it's Jill V and Chris R, and has 51 reviews. So let's begin. Jill Valentine, I think he meant to say Valentine, was found herself in a mansion courtyard with and no way into that house, but she had one zombie to contend with and no bullets of any gun. She had problem and zombie would not leave her alone. Jill finds Drake and swings Drake off. So like foreign for, what's that foreign for? And it adds zombie throw hitting it in the nailed him. Okay. The zombie chuckled, "I wilt eat your brains." No, not my brains. I need my brains. I will finish this later. You do not put that in a fic. If you're not going to finish it the first time, why would you even put it on fanfiction? Jesus. God. Oh. Alright, let's read chapter 2. At least use the chapter feature in this one. The zombies come closer, comes closer. Just a question. I thought it was one zombie. Oh well. And then it gets shot. Where did bullet come from, Chris? Jill said to Chris, "You saved me." "Yes, I did. I'm glad you're safe now, but we should have sex. It's important to remember that we human." Okay. Let's get down for brass tacks. What the heck is a brass tack? Then they had the sex, but it didn't go so well. The end. I didn't even understand that at all. At all! Oh my god! Well, luckily, this one only took me 2 minutes to read, so I will be able to fit another one in there. Yay! Let me just do something here. Gotta make sure I have the links to all of them so I can put them in the description, which, yes, will be right down there in said description. So make sure you view them. Alright. Back to Peter Chimera. Let's see. Copy his profile. I have to keep that there, too. Let me just space that here. Alright. This next one is a Digimon story. Oh boy, it's based on a request. Well, won't that be fun? Request. Who would request this more on to write anything? Alright. This is a Digimon story. No, it's an Alien, Predator, and Digimon crossover story called Digimon 3 Predator vs. Digimon. It's written by Peter Chimera. It's one of his 12 stories. It's rated T, it's English, it's sci-fi and adventure, and has 43 reviews. Let's read this, and hopefully we won't die. Chapter 1, Deadly Dropdown. Captor. Predator was going down in a tailspin. I ma goina crush, and he crushed into a highway dash L. What is it noise? Asked the limo driver. He was driving Digimon to his house on the island. It must be a alien. Don't you mean an alien? But it is friendly. Friendly? What does that mean? Digimon checked out his in front of him and wit all clear. What? Digimon checked out his in front of him and wit all clear. It doesn't even make any sense. Forget me about me. I go on ahead. And Digimon did a jump out onto road, but there was a fire. Help me. A kid was wrapped under the car. I really, really hope he meant to say trapped. She said, and who's she? What is there, just like a random, forget it. And Digimon went running to save a tea her at her. It is not a good time for our children to die. Well, that doesn't make any sense. Hui, that Digimon. He just barely lifted the car and it was not enough. I would need much more struggle to lift all of it. So he had to find a way. Meanwhile, Alien craft was all exploded. Is that even a word? Allexploded. That's a weird way to spell it. And they all fell down from Tremandual Blast Wave. God, this guy needs to get a spell checker. Was he writing this on Notepad? No, he's probably writing it on the Idiot's Guide to Morons. That's good. They should make one called that. But little kid was this safe form the car which fell off the brig lead. My work is in there. What? I don't even understand what's going on. There's like an explosion and kid with the brig lead and Strauss and who is that and what the heck is this? Let's see. My work is in there. Sorry, sir, but we have to be lucky that your daughter was not curl-led. Yes, that is true. This is like some foreign language that we don't understand. Next day, Gigimon woke up, wand, went to get ready, eat. You know how I feel about words that have Y's in them when there are not supposed to be Y's in them. This is not how you spell ready. READYIED. Okay, that Y does not need to be there. For work, but there was knockwhack. What the knockwhack? The door from a probably postman. I will get the mail. He opened the door. There was another predator. My brother is dead. Who at you? My name is Curlercack, and my brother died because his ship crashed, and the predator weren't invisible, and then shot lasers at Digimon 3. This guy, I think he's the only one who can understand what this plot is. Digimon had to avoid the THS shot, so he did THS splits. If he had power to see the Predator, but he had to figure it out. Look, you are behind the stairs, he said, but it was a trick, and when Predator realized he was not fooled, Digimon did a butterfly kick and knocked off the invisibility with gruesome attack. What is a butterfly kick? Oh, let's do a butterfly kick. My God. You kicked me in the invisible. You kicked me in the invisible! Oh, I'm not invisible! This story is horrible! My God! Okay. That is a just start. ND Digimon punched so hard that Predator went unconscious. Demimon felt licky that his bomb did not bomb the place. Licky. Okay, let's go be licky with a bomb. Ah! Oh, it tastes like bombs! I have to find out why the ship crashed, so Digimon and Predator... They were just apparently fighting, and now all of a sudden they're friends. Went to the FBI, but they said they can't go in there. Who are you to demand to come in? I am Digimon. You car not a Digimon. You are not one. Of the, yes I am. I am a new Digimon, but there is no time. Oh my God. He did not do that. Offers no tell. Digimon is a new Digimon, because there's not an actual Digimon that is called Digimon. He is a new one that I invented. Oh my God! I mean, Everyone knows the author's notes go at the top of the story or the bottom of the story. What kind of author's note is that anyway?
I'm starting to think they can't take credit too much.
So, they broke Ned in with a timeful kick to very door. The door crashed lead across the room so hard it flew across the room. The police tried to stop him, but they were trapped behind the door that flew. Oh boy, a flying door. You cannot take the evidence, and FBI shot at Digimon, but missed and hit Predator, so Predator went invisible and took the cop unconscious. When Digimon found the evidence, it said that the ship crashed because of FBI experiments. This is bad news, said the police. So I'll blow in high and wise. Now how will you get to your home planet? I will have to fly there in my ship, but thanks for your help. Here is a spear. Chapter 2, to help with the police. It's really short. Digimon experienced a knock at his door, but this time it was not alien attack, it was police. OT's okay to relax. We are here to congratulate you for exposing the FBI. So they had a dinner, but Officer Victorix did not come because he was very busy. The end. Once again, another horrible story that had absolutely no plot, made absolutely no sense, and the dude couldn't even decide on this Digimon person's name. I mean, this is just so stupid. And who is Officer Victorix? What is it? What's him having busy after? Oh my god. Well, I won't be able to fit any more stories onto this video because it's at the 12-minute mark. Even though I'm pretty sure the next one's just as short as this one. So, I'm gonna post the links in the description along with Peter Shamara's account link, so you can go there and review his stories yourself, or leave him a very hateful, mean message telling him that all his stories really suck. So, yeah, have fun, and don't forget to subscribe, because I really need subscribers. Later!